Welcome back to the Weekly Recap. I'm Matt Wacker. Missouri voters approved Amendment 2 on November 6th, providing for the legal use of regulated medical marijuana. However, the timeline for implementation means patients will likely have to wait a while, up to a year, before they can make a purchase. Nonetheless, cultivation facilities and dispensaries are gearing up to provide the product. We spoke with Rolla native Daniel Jones, who was going through the process.
Here, peace of mind, we applied to the State Department of Health and Senior Services for a dispensary here in Phelps County, in Rolla, Missouri, right here on Pine Street. We've also put in for an edible dispensary and facility, bakery. And then we also have put in for a large grow op. I think we'll end up doing several different grow facilities on that property. We did spend a lot of money on fees. It's I think close to $30,000 in total, maybe even a little bit more than that once it's all said and done. And that is a non-refundable thing, and I don't think that's something that bothers us, because one thing that we realized real quick, and everybody that's getting into this industry here in Missouri realizes, that it took a lot of money to get the Department of Health and Senior Services up and operating to be able to provide this industry to us with such a short time frame. With that comes a lot of expenses their way, so they're able to take that first slew of people like ourselves that have given all that money up, and they're going to use that to begin the, and then anything extra after that is going to go towards the veterans also. We have stores in four different locations all over Missouri. We have stores in Festus, Park Hills, Sullivan, and here in Rolla, which is our most recent store and one of our most successful ones. What I found is that it's not just here in Rolla that people are excited about Amendment 2 and the passing of this and the stores that are coming, and it's all over the state. We're finding that all of our stores' revenues have jumped just from excitement alone. People are coming in asking for the medicine, even joking, and then we have some folks that just don't know anything about the medicine coming in saying, is it here? Is it available? And we have to explain to them, no, but we're really glad that you're here asking for information, and we want to be able to give them the most accurate information we have. I think a lot of folks, one question that they have is whether or not doctors and physicians are going to be willing to prescribe that medicine to them when the time comes. And I think there's a little fear there, because they've never been able to have that conversation with their doctor before. Now, what I can tell people is that it's federally illegal for a doctor to prescribe marijuana, which is exactly why in Amendment 2 we ask them to recommend it instead, which is what everybody across the country does. A doctor can recommend the cannabis. They'll simply write that on a piece of paper. You'll take that to the dispensary, and that's where you're getting your medicine. It's going to be more seamless than people think, especially once we deschedule down to a Class 2 drug and get some good research out there. I think everybody's physicians are going to find, if they haven't already, that it's a non-toxic, safe alternative to all the junk that we've had to give people before. We here are expecting our doors on our dispensary at the latest to open January 2020, because that's the direction we first got. I don't look for that to be an issue, because we do want to make sure we do it all the right way. That's what we've done since the beginning of Amendment 2, is we said we're going to do this the right way. We're going to take the medicine to the people in the way that it should be. One thing I could tell folks is patience is a virtue. Since Amendment 2 passed, we're a third of the way there. We're already a few months past that, right? So we only have a little bit more to go. And then we're in good hands. We're in really good hands, because we're going to have the plant taking care of us.
The St. Louis District Small Business Administration held a Rural Strong workshop in St. James on January 31st. The event was designed to inform entrepreneurs, small business owners, and stakeholders about all the federal services and programs available in our area. Leanne talked with SBA's Tom Yoakum and Tom Diber at the workshop.
The Rural Workshop today was basically to get resource partners together that provide services to small businesses, and most of those services are free, and so we want to get the word out that for small businesses that need help with mentoring, work with business plans, in addition to needing access to capital through the loan program, that they can find that's available for them.
We have a pretty good handle on the big cities and how to get services to the big cities. But the rural communities have been kind of, I don't want to say forgotten, but just harder to get to. So, you know, we want them to know that they can have world-class resources and good jobs and economic prosperity, even out in rural Missouri or rural Kansas or anywhere. So SBA offices around the country are all doing this. We partnered up with the Department of Agriculture because they have a very big resource availability that they've already been pushing out, so we partnered with them. And what SBA might not provide USDA might. One big programs we have is government contracting. 8A is a certified program for any person who wants to have a company, start the company, and they can get a certification in this 8A program. So it's actually good for anybody. If you're looking for a contractor to do work, if I know they're in the 8A program, I know they actually have a certification to be a good quality contractor. It does make you eligible for government contracts. We do advise everyone at the workshops that, you know, if they're eligible for one of the programs that we have, one of the certifications, we do recommend they get that if they can, because it opens the door to a lot of opportunities for them with the federal government and outside the government.
Under the SBA program, we're well known for our loan guarantee programs. The SBA provides a guarantee for the loans, so the businesses would work with their local financial institution, and then they would provide SBA with the information we needed to provide a guarantee. So the loan guarantees are available for businesses that can't get capital elsewhere. On the SBA website, which is sba.gov, you can get a list of all the active lenders that are making SBA loans.
The success of the program, we're seeing more and more people show up to these, which is kind of exciting, and we're seeing more and more businesses get started. Our resource partner, the SBDC, down here in this part of Missouri, had 24 business startups last year, and that's just one little piece. So there's over 30 million small businesses in the country. SBA is the only agency that is the voice of small businesses. We provide access to, you know, capital, contracting, and counseling for anybody, and it's all for free.
Well, Super Bowl Sunday is this weekend, and that's really all I have to say about that. Sure, I have opinions, and I'm eligible to express them here as long as they're kept PG. But when it comes to that Patriots quarterback, I often find myself losing all sense of decorum. You know how it goes. If you don't have anything nice to say, wait till you're online and say it on social media. When it's over, I will be interested to see just how many people from the state of Missouri actually watched it, especially from the St. Louis area. This one stings, no doubt. So you tell me, are you going to watch Super Bowl 53? And if so, why? I'd really like to know. That's all for now. Thanks for watching the weekly recap. I'll see you next time.
Whether you live in Lebanon, Rolla, Salem, Thayer, or West Plains, Better Business Bureau wants you to use caution when ordering handmade quilts. This winter, you may be looking for something warm for your college students' dorm rooms, your elderly parents' bed, or even to stay cozy during movie nights on your couch. Unfortunately, more than 125 frustrated consumers are telling Better Business Bureau they were scammed. Here's what victims say happened. They find this e-commerce site through an online search or through a social media ad, and when they place an order through the site, they initially receive a tracking number and a confirmation email. However, when the quilt doesn't arrive weeks later, they can't find the company's contact information. In some cases, the website had shut down entirely. This report describes a typical experience. Quote, I was able to track progress through website for about a week. Now the website is gone, emails are not responded to, and I have not received what I ordered. There is not a way to get in touch with their so-called customer support. Now these online stores, they use a variety of names. Here's some you can watch out for. Gigi Blanket, Cotton Quilt Company, and Sleeptress. Additional names reported to us, Weirdo Stuff, EmmaCotton.com, eCrafta.com, eScrafta, Era Cotton, Joyce Quilt, Dusha, and others. So if you have fallen for the scam, please let us know at bv.org/scamtracker. We work very closely with law enforcement and will let them know what you tell us. And remember, before you do business, always vet an organization on bv.org.